Okay, last isolate gets underway, and this horde of about 20 riders approaching turn number one, and they're all going to get through, it looks like, in pretty fine shape. We've got about, my gosh, 6 riders going for the lead. And of course, one of those riders back there in fifth spot and just knifing his way through the pack is Clinton Whitehouse. Take a look at him. Watch him just devour these riders as they go down that back straightaway. And the orange bike, there he goes. By one, by two, he's already in the third spot. Oh, no, he got back in the fourth. The rider cut him off going into turn number 8. Watch Clinton Whitehouse, so as he comes down there for a front straightaway here, as he'll try and gobble up these riders one at a time, going around, coming down the final straight. And your final pack now coming wide out of turn number 9. And coming down the front straightaway, one lap down, 5 laps to go. And it's Alexander Wright out in front, but Clinton Whitehouse going to take the lead before they get into turn number 1. And Clinton Whitehouse takes the lead, the Bakersfield rider out in front. Alexander Wright running in second spot. Okay, 441, Matt Hall is still in that fray up there in the top 5 as well. And we'll try and pick up all the numbers and names for you next time around. Alexander Wright now starting to move away from the rest of this pack. Look at this great rush of third between Matt Hall, Frank Galanikos, and Rolla right on the inside, just passed all 3 of them. A great duel in the third spot between 5 riders, and the leader just turned in a 136.3, 93.7 miles an hour. 93.7 miles an hour for your leader heading around turn number 2. We've got to keep our eye on that pack of about 5 or 6 riders really putting in a great race here going around turn number 2. Alexander White, then Matt Hall in third. In fourth spot was 35. And that was Frank Galanikos. Then in fifth spot was bike number 148. That may be 248, Mike Schubert. We'll have to check on that next time around. Okay, your leader down at into turn number 8. And that race, that 5 rider race for second spot still goes on. And it looks like it's Galanikos. And it could be Robert DeWitt in that pack there, battling for third. We'll try and catch up all the names and numbers for you in that great race for second spot as Clinton Whitehouse just starts to motor away now as we get halfway flag. And it looks like Alexander White's going to have a tough time holding on to second spot because there goes 620 Roy Affley, fresh out of the Formula 3 ranks, getting into second spot over Alexander White. Okay, the difference between first and second, 7.77 seconds. So it's about a 7.5 second lead on your leader, Clinton Whitehouse, over Rye Halfley. Okay, Frank Galanica still in fourth spot. Matt Hall still in fifth spot. And bike number 130 still in sixth spot. And that is Kenny Notchman. So it's Kenny Notchman, is another one of those riders that's up there in that great race for second. And looks like now Clint Whitehouse is right away ahead. But we've still got a real firestorm of race going up there for second spot. And Alexander White now starting to feel a little bit of the heat from Notchman. And Halfley and Kalanikos and Matt Hall, as they're all barreling down on him as they go down that back straightaway. Your leader, Clint Whitehouse, coming up on some lap traffic going into turn number 9. And it looks like Ryan Halfley now really securing his position in second spot. It's getting a little precarious, though, as he kind of slows down around turn number 9. And it looks like riders like Galanikos and Matt Hall start catching up to him a little bit. Clinton Whitehouse, easy win. He's got about a straightaway lead over Ryan Halfley. Alexander White now has been dispatched to fourth spot as Frank Galanikos takes over that position. Matt Hall still in there in 130. Kenny Notchman still holding down that last place in that top leading group. Another great race back in the back of the pack between bike number 340 Steve Dyer and 655 Scott Waters. So we had Alexander White running up there in second position. Ryan Halfley got around him. And now Frank Galanikos, at least 25 years of his life, started racing 50cc bikes back in Brands Hatch back in 1960 in Evan. And Bill Ivey, who was a multi 125 250 world champion. So Frank Galanikos been around the world several times. In fact, he was born and raised in England. He's lived in Argentina. And now he's living in Southern California. Quite an international guy here as we got him out here on the racetrack. 40-year-old rider. And he's keeping right up there with the leaders. In fact, he's up there in third position right now. In fact, he's trying to close in on Ryan Halfley. And Ryan Halfley is a rider who, as we mentioned, was very successful in Formula 3 racing in the 125 GP class. And now just recently purchased, it looks like, a Formula 2 bike. And he's doing quite well, running in second spot. But look at Frank Galanikos. He's definitely on the heels of Ryan Halfley, and Halfley's second position may be in jeopardy as Matt Hall now goes around Alexander White, and Alexander White now goes down to fifth place. So Alexander White was in second, then he was in third, then he was in fourth, and now he's in fifth. He's giving it now. Okay, we're on the last lap, so Clinton Whitehouse is going to have an easy time of it. But let's see if Galanikos, the old veteran, can pick it up on Ryan Halfley on this last lap. Your leader goes up the hill. Clinton Whitehouse finishes the top three in the AMA 600cc Super Street race, the Lockhart-sponsored race out here about a year ago. Only had about two of those about 2 years ago, and that means that we're in short track circuit, that paved circuit up there in Bakersfield, and the Bakersfield rider having no problems at all around in turn number 8. That you can finally shut the motor off and push in for the win right now. It looks like Ryan Halfley, who was in danger of losing second spot, I think looked up and saw that Frank Galanikos was bailing down on him, and now it looks like Ryan Halfley's moved down a little bit, and your positions now are starting to get pretty much welded into place here as Clint Whitehouse goes down to get the win. The last race of the day, Clinton Whitehouse out of Bakersfield takes the win in the Formula 2 class. Ryan Halfley will come in second in the Formula 2 class, and the only consolation for Frank Galanikos is that he'll win the 450cc liquid cooled class. And it's Ryan Halfley, Frank Galanikos, and Matt Hall, and Alexander White. That's the top five, and finishing sixth will be bike number 130. He was up there in the frame for a while and then drifted back, Kenny Notchman.